Well, you know, it's fall weather, basically, and kids are back in school. For many, it's a time for them to catch up with their friends again. For some kids, though, going back to school means dealing with bullies again. Hopefully, there's less bullying going on this year. Governor Mark Dayton signed the Safe and Supportive Schools Act at the beginning of April. It went into effect this school year. This law requires local school districts to adopt a collaborative bullying policy, which includes cyberbullying. We spoke to one Edina high schooler who was cyberbullied before this new law was really even an option. And she says that her biggest regret is not talking about her experience with anyone.
You have to talk to someone, you know, and it's like knowing how I felt in that scenario, I know how difficult it seems and how difficult it probably is, but it'll help you so much.
So who do you talk to if you're being bullied? Well, today we are talking to our medical expert. Dr. Archelle Georgiou is here to discuss the topic of bullying with us. Let's talk about what a big issue this is and what is the official definition of bullying?
Well, the U.S. government says that the official definition of bullying is any aggressive, unwanted behavior that occurs between school-aged children that involves a real or perceived power imbalance. So that can be anything from physical and verbal abuse. It can be spreading rumors. It can be purposefully excluding somebody from a group.
And this is an issue that kids deal with on a grand scale, on a smaller scale, probably at all ages, really, isn't it?
That's right, and it can start in preschool years. So in any venue where children can begin to get together, from preschool to daycare to camps to sports activities, you can have bullying. It gets worse in the middle school time period and then, of course, can continue through high school.
And we just heard from that young woman from the Edina School District saying that it was a problem for her, but it had happened in the past. People carry this with them through life, don't they? It doesn't just affect you as a child.
Well, you can really have long-term effects from bullying. And so those who are bullied can certainly suffer from depression and anxiety. Their grades go down. They become withdrawn. But the thing to really remember is those who are the bulliers, as well as even those children who observe bullying, are affected as well. I was surprised to find out that observers of bullying tend to have more tobacco, alcohol, drug abuse, as well as tend to skip school. So really, there are no innocent bystanders.
Wow. What do you do as a parent? You know, as a parent, if your child's being bullied, you're certainly concerned. Let's talk first, though. What do you do if you think your child is the bully?
If you think your child is being bullied, have a low threshold for intervening and talk to your child about it. Try to get as many facts as you can and step in. What you do want to do is intervene immediately. Rationally, certainly, but intervene. You can ask another adult to help, of course, if you observe the bullying. Sure. Call another parent. Get their participation, model respectful behavior. You don't want to be emotional. What you don't want to do is to say, oh, just work it out. You're going to have to figure this out as an adult. Mm-hmm. You also don't want, if you observe bullying, you don't want to force an apology. You don't want to create a social situation that's public where you try to get the facts disclosed. Lots of other tips. But I think the takeaway message here is if you suspect it or see it, step in and stop it.
Archelle, such good advice. And let's hope that there is a change this year. Maybe the schools are dealing with it better. Maybe students are dealing with it better. And we'll see less bullying. Wouldn't that be nice?
I think we as parents can make a difference.
Yeah, that certainly helps. Thanks, Archelle.
Thanks.
You know, we have been working all week trying to get you and your family ready for this new school year. And we've touched on a couple issues, bullying tonight. We talked about nutrition yesterday and managing busy schedules, too. You can find our full week's coverage online at KSL.